Please rise.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Our text this morning is a presentation of our Lord, and it's the words of Simeon. Lord, you are now dismissing your servant, Lord, according to your word in peace. For my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel. Behold, this one is set for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign that will be spoken against, and a sword shall pierce your soul, so that the thoughts of many hearts shall be revealed. This is the word of the Lord given to us this morning. You may be seated. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, I know that each and every one of you have a song that you really, really like, your favorite song. It's a memorable song. And it's a song that will now stick with you for the rest of the day, because I know it's now stuck in your head. I know that there's a song that you will all be hearing now for the next couple of weeks. It's a song that's called Bugler's Dream. Maybe some of you are playing in your head, and maybe some of you have no idea what I'm talking about. Bugler's Dream is the theme song of the Olympics. All you have to do is watch NBC for the next couple of weeks, and you'll hear it over and over and over again. Now, most Lutherans and some Christians know Simeon's words of today. They know it as a song or a canticle, which you and I will soon sing. As a matter of fact, if you take out your hymnal and turn to page 29, it's there. It's called the Nunc Dimittis. Now, maybe you've been wondering, why is it called by this funny name? Well, you know, in the Greek, it's not Nunc Dimittis, it's Nun Apolluis. But in the Latin, it's Nunc Dimittis. You now dismiss. It's a song of dismissal. And this song of dismissal, my dear friends, can only ring true if the law has been fulfilled. We see today in our text that Mary and Joseph, they are faithful. They are faithful according to the law. The law demands that Mary present herself to the priest. And because she has given birth to a son, she was to present to the priest a sacrifice. This sacrifice is outlined for us in Leviticus chapter 12. She is to sacrifice a lamb, or if they cannot afford a lamb, two pigeons. We know that this sacrifice, this law is also found in Exodus chapter 13. You see, they were also required to redeem their firstborn son. Jesus, the Son of God, is to be redeemed. For that is what God ordained that the Israelites do. So therefore, the sacrifice that they bring to the temple, maybe you've never thought of it this way. They are making a sacrifice for Jesus as man, but they're also sacrificing to Jesus because he is God. You see, the lamb is present. Even though they didn't have a lamb, they had two doves. But the lamb is present. And this lamb is for the sacrifice of all mankind. You see, the whole law must be fulfilled for you and for me. For in the fulfilling of the law, we have peace with God. Why? Why must the law be fulfilled? Why must we be at peace with God? Or maybe a better way to say it, and actually the right way to say it, is that God is at peace with us. It's because of disobedience. It's because of our sin. It's because our sin has made us an enemy of our Creator, of our God. Yes, each and every one of those sins of idolatry, of taking His name in vain, of profaning the holy day, of dishonoring our parents and our teachers and all of those who are placed authority over us. Even those thoughts of murder and adultery and theft and being a false witness and coveting everything that is thy neighbor's. We sin daily, my friends, and we sin much. Thus we truly are, as you have just confessed, poor, miserable sinners. So that we can be at peace with God and God at peace with us, there must be a sacrifice. There must be a blood sacrifice. Our sacrifice isn't two pigeons, and I thank God that you don't bring two pigeons to me, or a heifer, or a goat, that I have to sacrifice unto an altar. Rather, thanks be to God that He is here, and He is your sacrifice. He is the Lamb of God, who Simeon was holding in his hands. There was the sacrifice. And Simeon said, "Which thou hast prepared before the face of all people." Before the face of all people, Jesus hung here as your sacrifice and as my sacrifice. Jesus is the one. He is the one prepared for sacrifice for you and for me. This is the song of dismissal. The sacrifice was present, not yet made, but it was present. And it would happen some 30 years later at a place called Golgotha. The song of Simeon is also a song of consolation. Simeon was awaiting the consolation of Israel. This was a promise to Simeon. Simeon was told by God that he would see the consolation of Israel. He would see the Messiah face to face, eye to eye. God keeps his promises, doesn't he? Simeon knew that Israel needed consolation. Simeon knew that Israel needed comfort and relief. In the face of Jesus, as Simeon looked at this baby, Simeon saw the peace of God. He saw the consolation of Israel. Not only that, he saw your consolation. He saw your comfort. He saw your relief. That's because you and I, we need this. We need comfort and relief and consolation. Many of you are still hurting because of the death of a loved one. Many of you are hurting because the cancer has returned or the illness is back. And where is there comfort in that? Many of you are still hurting because of those illnesses and pains that afflict each and every person, not only yourselves, but your family and your friends. Thus, this morning, we, as did Simeon, we will sing a song of consolation. We will sing a song of peace and of comfort and of relief. And it's right there on page 29 of your hymnal. We will also sing another hymn. It's called the Agnus Dei, the Lamb of God. And in that song is also a song of peace and of joy and of relief and of consolation. O Christ, thou Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, grant us thy peace. And he is here to give you that peace, as he gives to you and he says, take and eat. And then he gives you the cup and he says, take and drink. Peace be with you. Finally, the song of Simeon is a song of sacrifice. Simeon's song of departure in peace rings to the journey all the way to the cross. Peace is with God and peace is God. And it was God who secured the peace for you and for me. Looming in this child, as Simeon held this baby, looming in this child's future is an old rugged cross. Simeon knew this, and Mary and Joseph marveled at his words. And then Simeon blessed, and then he turned to Mary and he says, "Behold, this one is set for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign that will be spoken against. And a sword shall pierce your soul, so that the thoughts of many hearts shall be revealed." As our Lord's mother, Mary will see a horrifying death. Mary was present there at Golgotha, and she saw the horrifying death of her son. Something that you as a mother, for our mothers here gathered, that you, I pray, never see. But Mary saw it. She saw a son who was brutally beaten, nearly to death, flogged in a crown of thorns jammed onto his head. And then to top it off, he was nailed, not tied, but nailed to a cross. Mary endured this, and the soul, and her soul was pierced with a sword. Not only that, Mary also represents Israel. Mary is to see and to hear and to be cut to the soul by our Lord's teaching. And his teaching does the same to you and me. It cuts to the very marrow. It divides the law and the gospel. The law condemns us, as you have just heard. We break each and every one of those sins. We break each and every one of those commandments. Yet God forgives because of the blood of the Lamb that has taken away the sin of the world. At the cross of your Savior, many hearts will be revealed. You see, there were many hearts that rejected Jesus. You and I know this. You remember their cry, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" They rejected their Messiah. Yet other hearts were scandalized. They were shocked. They were appalled at what they were seeing. We thought this man was the Messiah. Now he's hanging from a cross. And then he goes into a tomb. And they lock themselves away in fear of the Jews. Yet, many will see Jesus' crucifixion as the Lamb of God. And I pray that's how you see his crucifixion. A crucifixion that took away all your sins. Dear Zion, the Nuptimitis, the Song of Simeon, reminds each and every one of us that despite all of our pain, despite all of our anguish, despite all of our fears, and yes, even our sin, by your salvation in Christ Jesus, you too, even today, will depart in peace. Even today, as you depart in peace, you have consolation, you have comfort, you have relief. As his body enters into your body, and as his blood enters into your body, all your sins are forgiven. Your faith is strengthened unto life and salvation. In this holy meal that he has now prepared for you, you partake of a foretaste of the feast to come. My dear friends, Simeon held the baby and looked into his eyes. He saw the Messiah face to face. Today, you see him in a sacrament. You don't see him face to face, but you take his body and you take his blood into your body. He is yours and you are his for the forgiveness of your sin. Today, my dear friends, you too can sing, "Lord, lettest thou thy servant depart in peace according to thy word." It is the will of God. It is his will and it is by the Lamb of God, who has taken away all your sins, that I announce to you the forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Thanks be to Jesus. Thanks be to the Lamb of God. Thanks be to the Child, the sacrifice for you and for me, the one who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please rise. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus, now and forever. Amen.